This quick guide to multiple myeloma will cover what is multiple myeloma, what is MGUS, risk factors, diagnosis, symptoms, and asymptomatic or smoldering myeloma.
Multiple myeloma is a blood cancer that starts in the plasma cells of bone marrow. Bone marrow is the spongy material in the center of your bones. It serves as the factory to make blood cells. It is here that stem cells mature into red blood cells, platelets, and white blood cells. White blood cells help the body fight infections. There are many types. Plasma cells are a type of white blood cell that makes antibodies, which protect the body from disease. In people with multiple myeloma, plasma cells become abnormal. They don't die and regrow as they should, and too many are produced. They crowd out healthy cells and cause many problems.
It's not clear why some people get multiple myeloma. Some things that can increase your risk of getting multiple myeloma are age, being 60 or older, gender, occurs more often among men than women, race. African Americans are twice as likely to get multiple myeloma. Weight. Being overweight may increase your risk of getting the disease. Genetics or a family history of the disease, and having a medical condition like MGUS or monoclonal gammopathy of undetermined significance also increases your risk of getting multiple myeloma. With this condition, you have elevated levels of M protein, but not enough for it to be multiple myeloma. MGUS can develop into blood cancer. However, only about 1 in 100 people with MGUS get multiple myeloma each year.
The important tests used to diagnose and track multiple myeloma are blood tests to look at your M protein levels and elements like calcium. The M protein level tells you how advanced the multiple myeloma is. It is important to know how this changes over time. Urine tests to look for related elements and see how well your kidneys are doing. Bone scans to look for thinned or damaged bone from the cancer. Bone marrow biopsy to look at the actual cancer cells and make a clear diagnosis.
When you look at your blood tests, it is important to know the level of your M protein. If your M protein level is greater than 0 but less than 3 grams per deciliter, you may have MGUS. This is not cancer, but with it, you have a 1% risk per year for developing multiple myeloma or related conditions. Healthy exercise and healthy diet habits can help prevent progression. Greater than or equal to 3 grams per deciliter, you may have asymptomatic myeloma with a 10% risk for active myeloma. Again, healthy lifestyle habits can help. Greater than or equal to 3 grams per deciliter, plus at least one symptom. You may have active myeloma. In this case, your healthcare team will recommend you complete your diagnostic tests and begin active treatment.
The most common problems from multiple myeloma are known as CRAB, or CRAB symptoms. The earlier these are found, the easier they are to treat. C stands for high calcium in blood or urine. This is caused by the multiple myeloma breaking down bone in your body. It can cause the blood to thicken. You may feel lightheaded or headaches. R stands for renal or kidney problems. The kidney's job is to clean the blood. Cleaning blood with too much calcium can damage your kidneys. If they aren't working well, you can feel weak, tired, or swollen. A stands for anemia. When myeloma cells replace oxygen-carrying red blood cells, you can feel very tired and weak and look pale. B stands for bone pain, damage, or fracture. Myeloma cells in the bone can cause lytic lesions or tiny holes in the bones. This weakens them and can cause them to easily break. You can feel pain from this weakness in the spine, pelvis, ribs, or skull. To learn about how to manage and cope with these symptoms, download our Frankly Speaking About Cancer Multiple Myeloma book at www.cancersupportcommunity.org/multiple-myeloma.
There are two types of multiple myeloma, asymptomatic and symptomatic. Asymptomatic, also known as smoldering myeloma, is when you show high M protein levels in your blood and urine tests, but you do not experience any CRAB symptoms. This means you will require active surveillance.
With active surveillance, you see a doctor regularly, but don't begin treatment until needed. The process of watching and waiting to treat your cancer can be difficult to deal with, causing you stress and anxiety about what the future holds. It can be frustrating to feel like you're not doing anything to fight the cancer. For information and tips on how to cope with active surveillance, visit www.cancersupportcommunity.org/active-surveillance.
The second type of multiple myeloma is symptomatic, also known as active myeloma. This is when you show high M protein levels in your blood and urine tests. At least 10% of your bone marrow biopsy test contains plasma cells, and one or more CRAB symptoms are present. This is when active treatment is critical and recommended.
Multiple myeloma is treated by a team led by a hematologic oncologist. These doctors treat blood cancers. They know about the newest and most effective treatments and clinical trials for multiple myeloma. It's helpful to talk with several doctors before you choose one that you'd like to work with. This will help you understand different treatment options and learn if you like one doctor or facility better than others. To find a hematologic oncologist who specializes in treating multiple myeloma, you can ask your primary care doctor or see the resources from our quick guide to multiple myeloma at www.cancersupportcommunity.org/multiple-myeloma. There you will find links to help you find a multiple myeloma specialist.
Tips for talking with your healthcare team. Your healthcare team will give you a lot of information. Listen closely and ask questions until you understand what is being said. Consider bringing a friend or family member to appointments to help you ask questions and remember what you're learning. Use a notebook to write down as much as possible, including test results and what they mean. Write down your questions so you can remember to ask them at your next appointment. Once you start treatment, use your notebook to keep track of side effects and symptoms so you can tell your healthcare team how you've been doing between visits. It's recommended that people diagnosed with multiple myeloma get a second opinion. Getting a second opinion doesn't mean that you don't trust your doctor. It means that you want to be certain that you know all of your options.
Let's talk next about treatment options. Most people with multiple myeloma will need to use more than one combination of drugs for their treatment over the course of their lives. When talking to your doctor about your treatment options, try to learn about different treatment combinations recommended for you and what they can do. Ask about side effects before you begin. Also, ask about different treatment paths.
Your doctor will make recommendations for your treatment options based on the current stage of your disease as shown by test results and symptoms, your values, goals, and preferences, your age, other health issues, and overall health, your health history and past treatment, your ability to tolerate side effects from treatment, and how far your disease has progressed, whether it has relapsed or returned after treatment, or is refractory, has not gone away with treatment. This is the end of this quick guide, Introduction to Multiple Myeloma. If you want to learn about multiple myeloma treatment options, we have two quick guides that you may want to watch. For newly diagnosed symptomatic myeloma, see our quick guide on treatment for symptomatic multiple myeloma. If you are relapsed, your multiple myeloma has returned after treatment, or if your multiple myeloma is refractory to treatment, see our quick guide on treatment for relapsed and refractory multiple myeloma.